Okay, so today we're going to learn about the slope-intercept form, which is the equation of y equals mx plus b. M is equal to the slope, and b is equal to the y-intercept. So, let's start with b, because that's easiest, yeah?
What's the slope?
So, the slope is where it's rise over run. And we can look at that in a second as we approach the slope, but start with B in terms of where do y'all think that this line crosses the y-intercept? If this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis.
Is it just the point at which x is zero?
Yes.
Or where it touches the y-axis?
So it's where x is equal to zero and it crosses over the y-axis.
Okay.
So that is equal to?
3.
Yes, okay. So, we can say that b is equal to 3. And then, we can look at slope, which is m. And so we have, which is equal to rise over run, which means, in essence, how much this goes up or down, which is the rise.
Like this, Miss Todd.
How much it goes up or down the y-axis, around the y-axis. Y form. And so it goes, this decreases 3 and moves, runs 1. So it could also, if the line is a different way, it could go up 3, but because this is a downward sloping line, we move down 3 and over 1. And because we're going down, it's a negative number. Does that make sense? Or do we need to go back?
How do you know you're going down?
Because we are going this way. If you go up that way, that's a positive sloping line. But if you're going in this direction, it's negative. No. That's always sort of the way it works out. And so we can now plug these numbers that we got. And negative 3 over 1 equals?
Negative 3.
Yes. And so we can say that y is equal to negative 3x plus 3. This helps us because now we can plug in any number of x and find where it equals on the y-axis. And we can also do this vice versa, where we can plug in any y number and see where it is at x.
I don't see where the line goes to negative 2. So from the equation, can we see where, like, can we determine y from where x is at negative 2?
Yeah, so we can say that, so if x equals negative 2, that's where you want to find. So we can say that negative 3 times negative 2 plus 3 should equal the y. So, negative 3 times negative 2 is 6. Plus 3
so
equals y. And so, y would equal 9 at x equals negative 2.
That's crazy.
Pretty cool stuff. Okay, do you have any last questions before we move on up to a quick, easy way to memorize this? So, y equals mx plus b. It's a nice, easy way to memorize it without having to sing, because I know singing is hard and challenging to all of us. So, the way I like to remember it is saying that y stands for your, and then m is mom, and then x, which is like a cross. Can stand for cross. And we can make it plural. So good grammar. And the plus looks like a little T. So we're gonna say it's the. And then we got B, so we can say crosses the bridge. And so that's a nice way to memorize that y equals mx plus b is in that formula as through, your mom crosses the bridge. You want to try it?
Your mom crosses the bridge.
Will it stick with y'all?
Yeah.
Yes.
Do y'all understand it?
Yeah.